It is Friday night currently. I wasn't able to go on the first day because of work, but I'm going the earliest chance I get, and that is in 10 hours from now. And yeah, like I said, I'm extremely hopeful. I will record my review as soon as I'm done watching the movie, and I will try to be as unbiased as possible despite all the hope that I have for this movie. I'll see you on the way to the movie. Years, multiple release dates, and an entire pandemic later, Brahmastra is finally in the theaters. I have to say, over these 11 years, this movie and the creators really have demanded a lot from its audience. They've asked us for their patience, trusting their process, waiting through all the multiple delays, hoping for the best, the biggest possible screen, watching it in 3D, and also paying stupid amounts of money for the tickets. Now, I fall into that part of the audience that has actually done all of this without any complaints. Since I started this YouTube channel, I've been trying my best to see the movies in the first 2 or 3 days of the release. And other than a couple of Marvel movies that came in the middle, I haven't seen people book so many tickets a week in advance and stand in queue to enter the theater. I went to IMAX, and that was the last place I expected people to bring whistles with them, but I was pleasantly surprised. It wasn't all perfect and flowery and oh so good. The movie had its issues that almost managed to take away from all the hard work and love that has gone into making this movie. The two main issues being the screenplay and the dialogues. The dialogues, my god, were they excruciatingly painful. This is something I've been saying since the trailer and the promos were released. My biggest worry was the dialogue writing. Because even in the trailer, there are dialogues like "Isha main aag se jalta nahi, mera kuch rishta hai aag se, aag mujhe jalati nahi." And light us roshni ka naam hai, jo hum sabke andheron se badi hai. And the dialogue writer Hussain Dalal very happily doubles down on dialogues like these. They leave such a bitter taste in the audience's mouth. I really hope they either change the dialogue writer or learn from their mistakes from this one and figure the dialogues out. Because if it wasn't for the dialogues, I think a lot of people would have left the theater happier. And it's not like Hussain Dalal is the worst writer in the world. He's written movies with Ayan like Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. He's also written movies like Two States. But this movie and the dialogues that he's written for this movie made it feel like no one else was available and we have to get Hussain on board. The two things with respect to which I would try to reason in my head as to why the dialogues were so bad are that in all of our excitement, I think we forgot that movies like this are perceived to be movies that are meant for kids. Even when it comes to a lot of these Marvel movies and superhero movies in general, the superhero genre in general for that matter, everyone always says that the target audience is the youth, Gen Z, the kids. Maybe they were trying to pander to that and felt the need to have exposition throughout the movie, and the dialogues are like spoon feeding the audience to a point where it's uncomfortable, especially in the scenes that Ranbir and Alia have with each other, where they're talking to each other about their love for each other. I could hear the entire audience cringe at some of these dialogues. So even though the creators may never have openly said it, maybe this movie was meant for the kids. And secondly, the characters in the movie are meant to be larger than life. So when there are informal dialogues, they actually sound really natural. But when it comes to using big words and Guruji teaching Ranbir Kapoor how to use his powers, the dialogues just seem so out of place. They seem so forced. So maybe in these larger than life scenes, it is difficult for the dialogues to be rooted, because you don't expect Guruji to be like, "Arey chal na kaam kar, अरे शिवा आग लगा दे. Maybe the dialogues were meant to sound grand, but they just did not. Even the cameo, who so effortlessly will deliver any and every dialogue that you give him, it just felt wrong. It was only his screen presence that allowed him not to fall prey to the dialogues that he was saying. The only saving grace for these dialogues was when it was either extremely informal and it felt like the actors were improvising amongst themselves, or when the bass and the strength of Amitabh Bachchan's voice was coming to their rescue. Coming to the second thing that really bothered me about this movie was its screenplay. The chain of events that occurs in the movie. While there is a story throughout, it is constantly interrupted with this endless love angle between Alia and Ranbir, and I get it. I get that their love story is important not only to the story in general but to Ranbir's powers in the movie as well. But you don't have to interrupt every single scene with it. Even a song as beautiful as Kesariya felt so weirdly inserted into the movie. When the characters are in the thick of things, when things are just starting to unravel, you've just inserted a love song. They're meant to be saving the day. They're just off romancing each other in beautiful Varanasi and looking gorgeous while doing it. We can appreciate that, just not at that time. That brings me to the third and last complaint that I had with this movie. The love track between Ranbir and Alia. Their chemistry was beautiful. They looked amazing on screen together. But it just felt so forced. Coupled with the dialogues, I felt like I was third wheeling on someone's first date where they had no idea how to make conversation with each other. It was so awkward. After a point, it was even painful to listen to.
Chalu ho gaya iska bakwaas.
Now that we have that out of the way, we can get to the good part. There is so much that is good about this movie. The movie flourishes every time it delves into the realm of mythology or the motives of these characters and tries to further their arc. But it flounders when the love story takes center stage. I paid good money to watch it on IMAX. I can happily say that my 450 rupees did not go to waste. The visual and the auditory experience was beautiful. The songs by Pritam and the original score by Tanush Tikku truly, truly enthrall you. When the bass of the background score kicks in, the seat vibrates. When there is some background music playing in one side of the theater and goes from one side to the other, you feel it. You feel like you're in the experience. I usually hate 3D, but the 3D in this was really nice. My pet peeve when it comes to 3D is that it is really dark once you're wearing the glasses. They color graded this extremely well. When it comes to their acting, I wouldn't say anyone was exceptional, but I also think that's because the script and the dialogues didn't allow for that to happen. You have to say dialogues that don't sound convincing, that sound like you're spoon-feeding the story to a baby. I imagine it's very tough to actually act. Amitabh Bachchan and the cameo were the only standouts, but that is because of their personalities and the screen presence that they had. That said, I think Ranbir and all the other actors nailed the movements that these superheroes have in the movies, the arm movements, because you gotta remember, they're working with VFX, so in reality, they don't really have things in their hands. It's not as cool as it looks on screen, so it's very tough, and it's all up to their imagination, how they visualize it, which then allows the post-production to add in the VFX to make it look cool. So kudos to them for that. Now, to those saying that there is no story and the movie is simply an empty spectacle, either their expectations are extremely high or they're just hating on the movie because they want to. There is a storyline. It is not path-breaking in any sense because at the end of the day, it is a superhero movie. There's only so much story that you can bring in. The way they mix the story with our mythology and our culture is genuinely refreshing. In fact, the way they've set up part 2 is actually really exciting, and I didn't think that would be the direction that they would choose to go in. They've managed to surprise me with their storytelling, and what more can you ask for? When it comes to the VFX, you can see that no stone was left unturned. We know that the VFX have been done by a company that has won multiple Oscars for their work. And despite having seen so many event movies, VFX in this had its own different twist. It had its own Indian twist, which was just so cool to watch on the big screen. Every time something cool happened on screen, there was a lot of clapping, there was a lot of cheering, there was a lot of whistles that could be heard. That's the kind of theater experience I really wanted, and I got it. My one worry was that in the trailers it looked like everything was done on a set, and there wasn't any real interaction of the VFX with the physical locations. That's not true. There is a lot of VFX that has merged with the physical locations, which just makes it feel more real. A quick couple of things that I would like to shout Ayan out for is that even though a lot of people may be annoyed by Alia's character, at the end of the day, her character was strong. She had her own personality in the movie. She had her own role to play. It's just that it made her scream Shiva too many times, and I think that's what stuck with the audience. Most importantly for some people, there's a cameo right at the start of the movie. There's a blink and you miss it cameo immediately after the interval. Trust me, reach the theater in time, buy your popcorn in time, or just don't move from your seats, because you do not want to miss it, but if you look away, you will. So yeah, all in all, I genuinely enjoyed myself. I was just so happy to see something like this come out of Indian cinema. It does have its issues, but it still manages to work because it is refreshing. It is a visual and auditory spectacle, like I said, and just the fact that we're getting a series of movies like this from our country, with our actors, with relatability, with beautiful, unnecessary dance songs in the middle, is amazing to me. I never thought I would see the logo of Dharma fly in my face in an IMAX theater. I hope this incentivizes other creators to explore and delve into fresh storytelling and take such leaps of faith. Because despite the numbers that this may or may not do, it is something new, and I really hope that it does well. Go watch it on as big a screen as you can, watch it with as many people as you can, because it genuinely is a fun experience. People were waiting till the post-credit scene to see whether there was a post-credit scene. Thank you, Marvel. There isn't a post-credit scene, so don't worry about that. I hope you like this new format of videos. I will also be doing a theories video for what we may see in the future and what we saw in this movie. Yeah, let me know what you thought about the movie if you've seen it. I would love to discuss this movie with you because I've been going on and on about it. I think all my friends are sick and tired of listening to me. Yeah, also let me know what you thought about the review. If you like this new format, if you didn't, what you liked, what you didn't, blah, blah, blah. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram at @SoVidyaBooch. That's my handle. It's my name. I keep forgetting to plug this every time. Thank you so much. I will see you soon with another review or another video. Till then, take care and peace. Also, I have my Vanarastra and Gajastra with me. Thank you. I just realized I completely forgot to talk about this. But hats off to the marketing team. I think they did a wonderful job, even though the event, the big event that was supposed to happen in Hyderabad a couple of weeks ago got cancelled. I think they've maintained hype. And even though they've shown so much, they've released 3 songs before the movie. There's still one song, various versions of some of these songs, and the background score that they haven't yet released. And multiple visuals that were released in the week leading up to the first day of the movie. But this movie still has so many new things to offer that it doesn't feel like you've seen everything. And I think that takes some really smart work, which these guys have clearly put in. So, yeah.